In just a few minutes, small business owners can now sign up for Blackfoot Communication Services. Whether it's dependable voice options or internet services, sign up simply by visiting blackfootsmallbusiness.com. Click on the services you wish, select an installation time and date, and you're done. Small business services at the touch of your fingers. Connect to more with Blackfoot Communications and blackfootsmallbusiness.com.
All right, welcome to the first press conference of the postseason. Montana will host Southeastern Missouri on Saturday night, 8 p.m. On ESPN2. We've got Coach Hauck with us, and we've got
Mitch Roberts. It's cold in here.
It is cold in here.
Golly.
I'll have Austin
borrow your hat next time. Can I borrow your hat?
I don't think Carhartt sponsors the
Grizz. Turn that logo inside out.
We got Mitch Roberts with us, who is a Terry Dillon Award winner yesterday at the Team Award Banquet, and Patrick O'Connell was the co-winner of the Tony Barber Award. So, Coach, we'll start with your initial thoughts on SEMO as they get ready to come here for the first round of the playoffs.
Sure. Well, we're excited for some Thanksgiving football. Obviously, it's great to be in the playoffs, and being the only FCS game that ESPN's chosen this weekend to show on national TV is also exciting, and I think that they think it'll be a good game, and it'll be a good scene in our stadium. So, Southeast Missouri is a tough team. They played a tough schedule, finished 9-2. They've got some personnel matchups that are of concern for us. They've got the all-time leading rusher, number 6, Hess, is the starter running back. They've got tall athletic receivers in King and Flournoy, 1-4, or not in that order, 4-1 in that order. I think they're physical up front on both sides of the ball. Defense is very multiple. They play a lot of different coverages and give you problems that way. So we're well aware of who they are. We know they went to Ogden, Utah a couple years ago and won in a playoff game. They're just difficult to prepare for. They played 3 different quarterbacks in recent weeks, but we're assuming they'll have their starter back. And then on the defensive side, they're not letting teams run the ball. I think they're giving up just over 100 yards a game. I think it's 108. So tall order to get ready for this one on what's sort of a short week coming off the rivalry game and with Thanksgiving week and all that. So we're deep into our preparation and excited to play. And, you know, I'd say we're hopeful that our fans will be there Saturday night on national TV and help us. We need them to help us get rolling again, and we're hoping to do that Saturday. So, you know, we'll take a page out of our rivals book from a year ago where you get beat down and then go on a nice little playoff run. It'd be great for us. So need to do that this weekend.
Questions?
Mitch or Pat, just knowing that you get another home game, what's that like?
Well, yeah, I'm very thankful for it. Any opportunity to play in Washington Grizzly Stadium in front of our fans is awesome, and I'm really looking forward to it, and yeah.
Yeah, same thing. I'm really grateful to get another opportunity to come here and play in front of the best fans in the FCS and actually in the country, so I'm very grateful for that.
Coach, you said you've been impressed with the way this team has bounced back and showed up early in the week, ready to prepare each and every week. What's the mindset, and then has it been kind of a similar feeling going into this week?
Just generally? Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, our in terms of coming off a game, is that what you're asking me, Sean?
Yeah, and then just being ready to prepare for the next week,
yeah,
despite what happened at Saturday.
Yeah, well, I mean, if you're involved in football or any sport, you're going to lose. And that's just what it is. When they're keeping score, the one team doesn't win all the time. And, you know, that just falls back into competitiveness. So we've got a competitive group. They'll be excited to prepare for a really good opponent in a playoff game. And I don't think that the competitiveness of this group would ever be in question.
What's it like preparing for a team that is in a different conference? There's not a lot of, you know, crossover as far as film and things like that.
That's real similar to non-conference games, and specifically the non-conference games we had this year. We didn't have crossover with them, so it's a lot like that, except it's, you know, current film, not a year ago, so you know the personnel a little better.
What makes their running back effective?
Well, he's got a lot of yards. They want to run the ball. They do, you know, with their quarterback this year, they've leaned a little heavier on the RPO game than just handing it off. But he's a big kid, 225 pounds, and they're willing to give him the ball and let him hammer at you a little bit, and he seems to like it.
Coach, logistically this week, preparation-wise, is it going to be the same schedule as you guys normally have, or will there be any alterations for the holiday or anything like that?
No, it'll be pretty much the same. We can, you know, we won't have class on Thursdays or Wednesdays, so we can go a little earlier, but it'll be basically the same.
You mentioned the quarterback. He's had a good year, but they've also played a couple of guys. I think he's maybe the starter's been hurt a little bit. Just to describe their quarterback situation and what the top guy does well.
The RPO game. He's got a big arm. He can rip it. Runs well enough to keep plays alive, get yards. Thought the Iowa State game in particular was interesting to watch, where he could run it as well as throw it. He made some big boy throws as well as generating first downs with his feet. Has no fear on fitting the RPO ball in, both on the glance or on the fade outside. Seems to read it pretty well. So he's in that system, he's highly effective, really good.
Pat, you just got done with a 2-month stretch. You think you stop me? I'm all the way up. Way up. I'm all the way up. I'm all the way up. Nothing can stop me. I'm all the way up.
Shorty, what you want? Shorty, what you need? My niggas run game. We ain't never leave. Counting up this money. We ain't never sleeping. No. Got V12s. I got 12 V's. Got bottles. Got weed. Got molly. I'm all the way up. Shorty, what you want? I got what you need. Shorty, what you want? I got what you need.
Teams that you're relatively familiar with, what's it like then trying to prepare for a team that maybe you're not as familiar with?
Yeah, like Coach said, there's not a lot of crossover that we have, but it's kind of it's the same preparation. You go in, you watch every single game, you get in as early as you can and prepare for this team. I don't think it's too different, except for the fact that we don't see them every single year. We don't know too much about them before looking everything up and doing our studying on them. So I expect us to prepare the same, and it should be a great matchup.
Coach, you've talked about just doing what you do well. How much does that cater to the fact that you maybe are unfamiliar? Like, there is no preconceived notion, or you haven't seen this team on film that much.
I didn't hear the first part.
You guys, you talked about how your team is so good at doing what you do well. I mean, how much does that play into this? You know, maybe having a faceless opponent.
Yeah. Well, you know, it's interesting when you're on the defensive side, everybody runs the same plays. You know, across the country, if there's 260 Division I schools, everybody's doing a lot of the same stuff with their own wrinkles. So you've fit the run game. You've seen the route combinations. None of that's new. So you just have to, you know, figure out what your game plan is defensively and then how you're going to fit those plays up. Then on the offensive side, it's about the protections. It's about, you know, trying to get a handle on their coverages and down a distance. It's about, you know, how much run game, how much pass game, how much RPO you're going to go in the plan. So all that's what we do during the week. I don't think preparing for these guys is really much different than the teams in our league because they've got a lot of similarities.
Any update on Lucas Johnson?
No, I have not seen him today.
If if you can't go, what did you think of Daniel Britt in the second half of that game, and what have you seen out of him the last couple weeks?
You know, I didn't watch the game, so I don't know. I got onto these guys. I meant I watched it live, but I got the worst seat in the house, so I did not watch the film.
And then I'll kind of follow up on that. If Lucas was, say, 80%, would you err on the side of caution and go?
I don't do hyperbole or I just I don't do that. I don't no hypotheticals. Okay. I don't. It's not productive for me to deal with hypothetical situations. So if you got a something that's not hypothetical, I'd love to answer it.
I got it. Have you ever had any run-in with their coaching staff at all? Do you know their
run-in like? Running?
Not like that. Have you had a crossover? Have you ever ran into them in your
career? No, this is a little bit rare in that regard, Lucas. Okay.
And then for the players, you know, what's the key to moving on from last week? Like the biggest takeaway from that? Was it at all a wake-up call of what you need to do to have success in the playoffs, or how did you see that?
Well, you just got to move on. Move on. You gotta flush it. You gotta learn from our mistakes. And I mean, now that we're in the playoffs, it doesn't matter. We're 0-0, so we get a fresh start, and we get to go and show the country what we can do. We gotta play better, obviously, and go do our thing. So we're 0-0, and that's where we'll start again.
Yeah, I would second what Pat said. Flush it. Move on. And you know, there's going to be things that we'll watch today from the film and learn from it. And, you know, just got to improve, you know, going into this week preparation-wise. And, you know, it's a new season. So looking forward to it. And, yeah.
Bobby, the big guy, got five teams in and a couple top seeds. So what did you just think of the overall regular season for the league, and how do you think it prepared you for the playoffs?
Well, that remains to be seen a little bit. You know, the earlier conversation here was there's a little crossover. How do you gauge things, you know? But I think our league was strong. I mean, I suppose I've been following it, coaching it long enough to have a pretty good gauge that our league was good. I'll be interested to see how some of these matchups go their first couple weekends, because I think our league's strong. Like, real strong.
Anybody else? Thanks, everyone.
Simple.
Join Town Pump's Pump It Up Rewards Plus program and never pay full price for fuel again.
Save 5 cents on every gallon every day at any Town Pump across Montana.
Plus, earn and redeem points on your favorite in-store items to get free stuff with our clubs.
Stop in and pick up a rewards card. Download the Pump It Up Rewards Plus app today.
Or visit townpump.com/rewards to register and start saving. Yeah!